Yeah, look, Matty made a great play, pass to Casey, and Casey using his speed and athleticism. I told him to dunk it, but obviously he didn't take that to heart. But no, it was good execution, and you know, pressure Faustus doesn't get any more pressure than that. And so I was a knock the one down, and we missed the second on purpose. Well, I thought he pushed him in the back. He was, you know, Casey was past him, and the only chance he did was not to play at the ball. He played at the man, and I thought that was an automatic. But look, it's not the only mistake they made, and I'm sure it's not the only mistake we made. So it's okay. Yeah, it was the time on the clock. There was 3 seconds left, and you know they could take the ball out of Dollar's hands and double team him. And so I kind of thought that might be a distraction or a decoy. And Casey was, you know, he had the hot hand all night, and he was playing great. And he hit a big 3-pointer for us, you know, a minute beforehand. And you know, he was feeling it that night. And if you're feeling it, you know, I'm going to go with you more times than not.
Casey, what was going through your head when you're standing at the foul line?
Honestly, nothing. I mean, I shoot free throws every day of my life, so I mean, it's just routine, kind of like, you know. I was kind of mad I had to miss the second one, percentages, but it was good. I wasn't really thinking about it.
Do you like that sort of pressure situation, game on the line?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, that's what we play for. I mean, growing up, you know, you in the backyard, you like 3-2-1, you shoot the ball. You know, that's just kind of the thing that you know, grow up living for.
And the roar that went up when that first time went down, is that? Heard something like that before?
What's that?
The roar of the crowd.
Oh, yeah, it was amazing, man. It was, I wish I could just keep hearing it over and over and over again, but it was definitely a great environment.
Do you feel like on the back of that game, you took the time to work in, or you had the injury, do you feel like now you've really arrived in this league?
I'm still getting better. You know, my coach and my teammates doing a good job, like helping me like understand the game a little bit more. So I'm just going to stick with it and try to get better each and every day.
What are your confidence levels like now compared
to
even just a couple of weeks ago?
I mean, I'm pretty confident. You know, I've always been a confident person, confident player. I just got to keep my aggressiveness high.
Trev, the play before Casey's
layup,
Casey's foul, talk us through it. Did you think
Markel
was going to get the ball and
how disappointed
were you that you couldn't get that ball together?
Yeah, well, I just seen Burson got 7 rebounds. So it was, you know, a corner shot that we did a pretty good job defending. Actually, I thought Worthington was going to shoot that ball, and it was like, oh no, not again from you know, last year, I think it was, or the year before. But we did a pretty poor job on the glass tonight. Oh, you know, to get away with that win, and when you don't play well, I thought, I said to the guys after the game, it wasn't pretty. We turned the ball over way too much, and our work ethic on the glass wasn't our normal self, but our spirit was first class. We stayed in the comp, stayed in the game when it could have gone either way, and you know, we'll take a lot from that, and it's going to require us to keep improving.
What changed after that first 5 minutes for you guys of the game was pretty ugly offensively? What changed after that? How did you find that play?
Sub Casey off. No, look, we just weren't in rhythm. You know, we sloppy with the ball. Well, I think we had 3 turnovers in 4 possessions. I think Dollar got the 2 points from an open look, but we were just sloppy, and we needed some energy, and you know, we just made some a couple of subs to get that energy level back up and get in the competition. And then just before half, I think we were 6 up, and we didn't really capitalize on that. I think we went down 2 points at the half. So you know, we come back, and like I said, it was a grind out game. It wasn't pretty on our standard. We turned the ball over too many times and gave them second shots, and they were ticking the scoreboard over.
Trip was a pretty big call taking that off the floor late. Can you walk us through your thinking?
Yeah, I wanted another shooter out there for Jesse out there. So Jesse's a little bit more agile with that mid pick and roll. They were playing with Starks, and just felt that if we're going to win it, you have to go out and win the game. You don't have to defend the game to win. And I wanted Jesse on the floor to stretch him, because he shoots a great clip. Oh, he knows. He's just passionate, same as we all are. So he was, you know, he was dominant in that third quarter, and he just got a little bit tired and picked up the 4th foul. And but look, he was a real big factor for us to get the lead in the third, and to maintain it.
Is the next step for him finding that consistency? He seems to dominate in spurts at the moment.
I think it's the team to find him. Like, I think at the halftime he only had 3 shots, and that's not enough for Nate. We need to get him better looks, and then in the third we started to, you know, get the ball to him at the right areas and make sure our offense is working to get him. So we're still, you know, what are we, 10 games with him? I think he missed one, so we've still got some work to do with him.
Do